UFO reports of orange balls of light are spiking all over the world.
Whoa, I'm getting a series of lights right there. It's moving.
But most witnesses are filled with terror and dread.
She starts screaming. She won't stay out after dark.
What emotion do you associate with it?
Fear. Those who see the lights.
I was employed by the Missouri State Highway Patrol.
Report strange occurrences.
The farther I drove, the closer this light got to me.
And they want these terrifying encounters to stop.
They're frightened. Some of these people are just scared out of their minds.
Whoa, there they are.
There it is.
Video evidence seems to show that something is going on that we just don't understand.
Wow. Whoa, whoa.
But what is it?
There is no explanation for it. We have no known source for what is causing this.
Is this presence a warning of things to come?
This orb stopped 3 feet from me. And I heard a voice say, don't touch it or you'll die.
This is case number 92207, Dark Presence.
We investigated balls of light, orbs, last year in Indiana. Guess what? They're back. And this time, we're going to investigate a whole other aspect of these. Kind of a dark presence. People are reporting a frightening UFO contact that involves nightmares, headaches, terrifying premonitions, and sometimes actual confrontations with the orbs.
These spherical UFOs are really nothing new. If you go back into Project Blue Book, there was all kinds of reports of spherical UFOs. This has been going on for a long time, and it's a huge part of ufology to understand what these balls of light are.
The spike in orb sightings is a worldwide phenomenon, from Puerto Rico to Australia. But we're seeing a pattern of reports in Missouri, Indiana, and Arizona for some reason. So we need to investigate this phenomenon to find out what's going on.
These orbs aren't necessarily UFOs. There's so many conventional explanations that don't associate with any kind of communication whatsoever.
There's conventional and there's unconventional. So I think that's what we need to explore. And we're going to try to get to the bottom of what this presence means. Respected investigator Ted Phillips has been exploring the orb phenomena for 2 decades and focusing on a particular area in the Ozarks of Missouri that he calls Site X. People are reporting nightmares, animal mutilations, hauntings, and a deep fear of these uninvited guests. People are so frightened by these orbs, they don't want to come forward.
Hi, Ted. How are you?
Hi, guys.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
But investigator Ted Phillips has gained the trust of this community, and he's sharing with us some horrible accounts that witnesses have told him.
We've had a great deal of new activity in the light ball area. I wanted to bring along some photos and some video to give you a better idea of what we're talking about. The light balls range in size from baseball to basketball. They'll fly around, maneuver, sometimes go into a sort of yo-yo pattern, up and down, and then to the right and the left, and do this for a long, long time.
There it is. Wow. Whoa, whoa. I got to call Ted, man.
The longest duration sighting was over an hour and 30 minutes. So you're eliminating things like gas or earth lights because of the duration. Now, recently, more of the objects have been seen on the ground. So there is a little bit of the fear factor.
What are the effects on humans?
Dry throat. Some nausea, severe headaches, colors in their vision.
We've never heard stories like this before from anyone about the interactions of orbs with human beings. So we're looking at a close encounter of the fifth kind here.
Whoa. Wow, that was an awesome.
There it is.
Ronnie, turn your camera on.
Have there been any fatalities or injuries in relation to these sightings?
We had one case, one of the very best, and a little girl's jumping on the trampoline. She sees this close, a light bulb. And she slips and twists her ankle just a bit. She starts screaming. Her mother tells me, said she won't stay out after dark. Has not since it's happened.
So the daughter is scared of these things?
Oh, yes, she is.
The story that Ted is telling us is rather hard to fathom. How could this be happening, and yet the media hasn't reported any of this? I'd love to interview this woman that had this confrontation, but Ted says she's just too scared to talk.
Are there any deaths that you can ascribe specifically to these objects?
We had a case in which the ranch owner and his son were sitting there one afternoon, and they saw a small light bulb. Well, he had his three labs lying on the ground nearby, and the light bulb makes a low pass over the three dogs, gets their attention, and it starts moving away towards a small clump of trees. And the dogs follow. And suddenly he hears terrible cries from the dogs. And he runs down there, the light bulb is gone, and he finds the three dogs as three sort of gooey puddles on the ground.
The dogs were liquefied?
Mm-hmm.
This is a community with a problem. Where do you go when you're being plagued by strange balls of light that are actually making your children cry and also causing harm to plant life and livestock?
I think there's an indication in the fact that the thing lured the dogs. That puts it into an entirely different realm.
What do you think these objects are?
The one thing I can tell you is these things are real, whatever they are. So many witnesses seeing the same things, and they are physical.
Are we dealing with some kind of malevolent force here?
Yeah, I really think, based on what happened, you have to go with malicious intent.
This is an incredible video and a story that Ted has shared with us. We have to analyze the video. But interesting to note that just 30 miles away, we have a first-hand account of orbs making nightly visits. And they're also linked to a dark presence.
I was employed by the Missouri State Highway Patrol. One night, I noticed this light off to my left. The farther I drove, the closer this light got to me.
Doug Schultz is a 31-year veteran of the Missouri Highway Patrol. While on duty, he witnessed a single orb every night for a year. So many residents in the area saw this light that it became known as the North View Light.
In December of 1992, I was in Marshfield going across the exit 100 overpass. I noticed the North View Light off to my left. It was brighter, larger, and closer than I'd ever seen it before. I went west on Highway 38, and the farther I went, the closer this light appeared to get to my patrol car. It was really close, really large, so I decided I was going to stop my car and turn the engine off and see if I could hear this thing. I stood with the door open, got my binoculars out, and I got a good look at this thing. It was probably about no more than a quarter of a mile from me, and it was about 80 to 100 feet above the ground, hovering immediately over the county road. My patrol car was equipped with a spotlight, so I decided that I would shine the spotlight on the object just to see what might happen. As soon as I shined the spotlight on it, this craft, without making any noise, took off and was out of sight in less than a second. A friend of mine lived almost directly below where this light was hovering at the time. He was a cattle rancher. We found it.